Joel, the tobacco industry tonight is blasting a report by the U.S. Surgeon General about smoking, even though it hasn't yet seen the report. The Tobacco Institute calls the report a publicity stunt, a propaganda barrage, and rehash instead of research. The report on the 15th anniversary of the Surgeon General's report linking cigarettes to lung cancer confirms smoking's dangers with a special warning to teens and pregnant women. Our Vivian Rosenberg asks smokers why they keep puffing.
I like to. I mean, I enjoy it. That's it.
It's a bad habit. Just a bad habit. You're just hooked on it. I don't know. It's. I wish I could stop. I just can't.
I smoke occasionally. I don't know why I continue. I think it's more a sociable thing. You know, when my friends smoke, then I'll smoke. If I'm drinking, then I'll smoke.
Habit, I'm sure, but I enjoy the habit.
Sir Walter Raleigh didn't know what he started when he bummed that cigarette from an Indian, did he?
It's a nasty habit.
Well, proving again that nothing is so permanent as change, John and Greta Rideout are back together again. He's the young Oregon man charged with raping his wife. She's the wife who, under a new state law, tried to put him in prison. Instead, he was acquitted. Now they've reconciled. Says John, the trial brought us together. Only in America. The Lee Marvin breach of contract trial gets underway tomorrow in California in a case which could have far-reaching repercussions in a society where living together has become commonplace. The courts have held that the actor's former live-in girlfriend Michelle Triola Marvin has the right to seek compensation for the services she rendered and the career opportunities she sacrificed. This is a new twist to that old problem, the high cost of leaving. Until now, courts have generally ignored claims made by parties who are not legally bound. And according to Chicago attorney Barbara Hirsch, many such couples are getting nervous. They want something on paper.
They're asking for waivers of cohabitational rights contracts, a name that doesn't really mean very much, and we don't know what it'll mean in the law. But what it's saying is, I am not making a contract to live together. I'm not giving up anything. All I'm saying is we're living together because it's fun and we like it that way, and I'll never make a claim against the other person for any property or any money. And we think that that's at least better than having nothing.
Ms. Hirsch, who has written books on divorce and living together, believes the ultimate result of the Marvin case may be a boost for that old institution of marriage.
It's possible, because if the only benefits that people had from living together were this feeling that they were free and easy and didn't need lawyers and didn't need courts when they broke up, then they're not going to have that feeling anymore, and they're going to think, well, either I'm going to live alone because I don't care about this person enough to make the real commitment of marriage, or let's get married and brave it out.
A Palm Springs restaurateur who finds himself in the same situation as Lee Marvin is writing a book about it. Terry, he's got a great title. He calls it Palimony.
Tim Weigel puts together Fractured Football, and we get more of the cold news from John Coleman after a short break, so stay tuned.
Let's see. According to my calculations, this should be...
You're in East Texas, Kirby country. See, all this forest land covers more than 630,000 acres.
They sure grow tall here in Texas.
Kirby Forest Industries is the green and growing part of Santa Fe Industries. Kirby develops its own forest lands to supply its own plants that manufacture plywood, particle board, and lumber products for residential and industrial use. In addition to Kirby, Santa Fe Industries include the development of oil, coal, real estate, construction, and a fast-growing transportation network of truck lines, pipelines, and the Santa Fe Railway.
Come on, Rosie. We better get moving. Somebody might come by with a saw and put us to work.
Santa Fe, energy-producing resources, energy-saving transportation.
When you prepare a main course, you want quality at an economical price. That's why Jewel's Grade A poultry is a smart choice. That Grade A assures you of poultry that's tender and rich in flavor. And through Saturday, during Jewel's poultry sale, you'll also be assured of economical prices. Like whole fryers, only 47 cents a pound. Then for dessert, top a home-baked creation with Golden Farm Stand bananas. Only 18 cents a pound through Saturday at Jewel.
WCLR, blending the best of the superstars, Manilow, Streisand, Sinatra, Mathis. WCLR, we think you'll like us now more than ever. Listen.